Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. All praise be to Allah, who is the sustainer and creator. Peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad and all the prophets from Adam to him. Peace be upon them all. At the heart of Mevlana Rumi's moral teachings, we find three important virtues, which are love, muhabba, compassion, rahma, and respect, musamaha. All of these golden virtues, he believes, sprang forth from the Quran and also from the beautiful character of the Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him. He understands them as follows. You respect all humans, show compassion to all, and you love them all. After all, they are the creatures of Allah. Allah's love, Al-Vedud, all-loving for Mevlana, is the very essence of life, the nucleus and source of all physical and spiritual beauty. It infuses and encompasses everything in the universe. As far as human being is concerned, the Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him, as the symbol of the perfect human, as the representative of all the prophets, reflects most the virtue of love in his personality and character. His love of Allah, meaning Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's love of Allah, muhabbatullah, is an exemplary for all, as understood also Mevlana. Just to illustrate such remarkable quality of the Prophet, it is sufficient to quote this Turkish poem that we find today, which is anonymous, inscribed on the wall in the Mevlana Museum, in the Mevlana Shrine. And those who visit will see them easily on the wall, on the left-hand side. It is Turkish. It's a beautiful Turkish poem. I will quote in Turkish first and also translate. Muhabbetten Muhammed oldu hasıl, Muhammedsiz muhabbetten ne hasıl? Out of sheer love, there sprang, gushed forth Muhammad. Then, no love is there at all without Muhammad. For Mevlana, the Quran and the Prophet and the path of the Prophet and Islam as a whole all represent the love of Allah in the world. Hence, all have come to call humanity back to the love of Allah, Muhammadullah. As Mevlana himself expresses this beautiful call in one of his rubais. Let me give the translation. The path of the Prophet is the path of love. We are the children of love. Love is our mother. Love, you are beyond the tent of our body, our love, behind our nature and our soul. And again in the Masnavi, know that it is the waves of love, love of Allah, that turn the wheels of heaven. It is through the energy of love that we communicate from heart to heart. There is a way from your heart to mine, and my heart knows it, because it is clean and pure like water. When the water is still like a mirror, it can reflect, behold the moon. In following the footsteps of his beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him, Mevlana personally emulated, embodied, and internalized his moral character with love. Even one can conveniently characterize the Masnavi, the magnum opus of his books, as a mirror reflecting the moral and spiritual treasure of the Quran and the Prophet in the language of love. Love is the wellspring of creation, the meaning of life. Love is one of the attributes of Allah, says Mevlana, who is without peer and self-subsistent, self-sufficient. Divine love is the fount of creation, the sovereign cure for all disease. It is the remedy for arrogance. It is the remedy for conceit. And it is the source of all good plan. Love for other than Allah, therefore, Mevlana says, is only a fleeting, a passing fancy. He looked upon all people, meaning Mevlana, regardless of their origins, complexion, races, languages, demographic conditions, with what I call an eye of basira, internal eye, clairvoyant and compassionate eye. And therefore, he quoted various verses from the Quran referring to the mercy of Allah. And he said, for example, La taqnatu min rahmatillah, inna Allah ya'furu dhunuba jami'a. This is the month of Ramadan. We have to be vigilant at all nights asking forgiveness of Allah Almighty. And this is Surah Zumar 39:53. Despair not the mercy of Allah. Allah, after all, forgives all the sins altogether. So this is a universal lesson for all and appealed according to all humanity, according to Mevlana. He says again in the Masnavi, plant the love of the noble ones within your spirit. Do not give your heart save to the love of those whose hearts are happy. Go not to the neighborhood of despair. There are hopes. Go not in the direction of darkness. There are suns. The heart leads you into the neighborhood of awliya, meaning friends of Allah. The body leads you into the prison of water and earth. So give your heart food from one who is perfect with his Lord, who is in accord with it. Go seek advancement from one who is advanced. Let us remember here Mevlana's exhortation, advice to his beloved son Bahauddin Veled. He said, O Bahauddin, if you wish to love your enemy, and if you wish your enemy to love you, say fine and good things about him for 40 days. Such an enemy will become your friend, because there is a path from the heart to the tongue, and as there is a path from the tongue to the heart. Let me conclude with Mevlana's golden advice to us of all. Mesnevi, volume number 6, 2451. Do not regard any infidel with contempt. Do not see anyone who has no faith with contempt. Do not scorn him. Do not scold him. Do not belittle him. Why? Mevlana says, there may be hope of his dying a Muslim. There may be hope for this person whom you contempt. There is a possibility for him or her to die as Muslim. Then let us all treat one another with respect, compassion, and love. May Allah's peace and blessings, mercy, love be upon you all. Assalamu alaikum.